also the defending champions, the eight-time champions China, off to a flyer against Korea, two love up. Sudirman Cup final, of course, this is the fourth time that these two nations have met each other in the final of the Sudirman Cup. Now this is a must-win situation for Korea to extend the final beyond the three matches. Go Sung-hyun and Lee Yong Dae up against Liu Xiaolong and Qiu Zihan. The Koreans, well, ninth match of the week for Go Sung-hyun. Of course, he played the first match this afternoon in the mixed doubles. Lee Yong Dae, twice an Olympic medalist, of course, Olympic mixed doubles champion in Beijing in 2008 in Liu Xiaolong.
Okay, gentlemen, heads or tails?
The aerial of Paralympics. Side.
Who will serve?
Side nearest to us. You would have thought we'd have that sorted out before we arrived on court. If you win the toss, what are we going to do?
Me?
Are we going to choose ends or?
Me. Who will receive?
Other things on their mind.
Yeah.
Getting ready.
Well, Lee Yong Dae, an absolute megastar in his own country. Three finals from their last four tournaments. One, of course, the All England Championships. Unseeded they were. And also won the India Super Series. And very importantly, in the final of that India Super Series, they beat their opponents of today. So the Koreans are number two in the world ranking. As you can see, a fairly new partnership. They did actually play a couple of tournaments in 2011, US Open and the Canadian Open, won both of those, but really got together after the Olympic Games, after the retirement of Jung Jae-sung, with whom, of course, Lee Yong-dae won the Olympic bronze medal in London last year. A win-loss record for the year, five finals, winning two of them, the Korean Super Series and the Asian Championships. Three times beaten finalists in Malaysia, Swiss Grand Prix and the India Super Series. And of course, the India Super Series, as I've already mentioned, was the last time that they met. Two straight games it was for the Chinese pair. In fact, the Chinese pair have won the last two occasions that they've met, because they also met in the quarterfinal of the German Grand Prix in March earlier this year. Carol Iariel, our umpire, and Chen Chia-shen of Taipei, the service judge. So the psychological advantage, definitely with the Chinese, having won the last two matches, and having watched Taeyun and Fu Haifeng playing against Denmark in the semi-final yesterday evening, and losing to the world number ones, Matthias Bo and Carsten Mogensen, in two straight games. I'm not at all surprised that this men's doubles pair has been selected in place of the world and Olympic champions. Disappointing performance by Taeyun and Fu Haifeng yesterday.
Ladies and gentlemen, On my right, Korea, represented by Ko Sung-hyun, Yong Dae. And on my left, China, represented by Liu Xiaolong, Qiu Zihan. China to serve, Liu Xiaolong to Yong Dae. Love all, play.
So this is obviously absolutely crucial for Korea if they want to keep in this Sudirman Cup final. They have to win this men's doubles. And of course we progress to women's singles, and if Korea could win the women's singles, then it would all be down to the women's doubles. But there's a lot of ifs in that scenario.
Service over. One love.
Fifth meeting between these two pairs, they really should know each other's games pretty well. But an interesting statistic, Morton, is the fact that all four previous matches, though honours have been shared, obviously, all matches in straight games.
In straight games, I thought you were going to say three sets. I don't know really which one to choose.
Serve over, one all.
Who's going to win? But only the day will say and tell. So I'm really looking forward to this match. I think it could be a cracker.
Service over, 2-1.
Well, a Chinese pair only played one match so far in this Sudirman Cup campaign. That was the very first match in the group against India.
Service over, 2-1.
Only two straight games, but they were tight games. In fact, the first against the Indian pair of Dewarka and Chopra. 25-23. Oh, my goodness.
That's well done. Oh, yeah. That's quick. That's really quick.
Now, in contrast to the World and Olympic champions, which of course are also Taiyun and Fu Haifeng, a left and a right hander, with this combination, it's this man, it's the left hander, that likes to go forward in this combination.
It's easy to see he's the exciting one. He's the one that can really play all the shots in the book. But can he control them?
Well, that wasn't too shabby.
I knew you were going to say that.
Qiu Zihan. Sort of walked through confident as he played this cross court, didn't he? Confident reaction after the winner as well. What a return.
Brilliant serve.
Now, of course, right at the start of this match, Morton, we know that
the Korean pair chose ends.
Starting hitting with the drift. Now, what would be the theory in that?
That would be that if it goes to three, if the interval on the change side, they will have bad and good side, and then play against the drift.
Stay on the court.
Which gives the option of defending if necessary and moving opponents at the back of the court.
But that's only if it goes to three.
Yeah, exactly. So that word again, if.
If I was ready, I would possibly choose opposite. first day on his side first. Three. Get the first set under the belt. When it comes to the third, you're so much into the match and you have adjusted to it that it doesn't become so important anymore. Much more important to win the first set, get off to a good start.
No serve is short of the mark. All right. Yeah, and even on the serve, the low serve,
8-3.
On that far side of the court, you've got to push through a little bit more, haven't you, because of the drift.
Yeah, one shouldn't think that comes into effect, but it does.
Yeah, well, the umpire's just got the score wrong. It is 4-7. There we go. Just a little touch pad that the umpire has, so any little mistake, it's registered. Very fast rallies, isn't it?
Push that one. This one is a little bit too far. Either he should go for the mid-court area or really try to rip it cross court. He didn't consider the pressure on his opponent.
Service over, 8-5.
That's good defending by the Koreans. Oh, mamma mia, well played by the Chinese pair here. Really well played.
Service over, 9-6.
What an exciting player Li is to watch.
From the same province as Lin Dan. Left-hander, exciting dynamic. Any similarities? Obviously
maybe.
Different discipline, but
maybe the same coaches.
Exactly.
That's beautiful. That is so good by Li Yong Dae. Able to take that one completely across court. Not many can do that. That one there, that's a beauty.
8-9.
We're just about even in the fan base here. Supporters for China and Korea.
Service over.
But the string didn't break.
No. And I know that Easily fit enough, but I somehow have a question mark on the psychological effect of having lost the mixed doubles, the first match in the final, and whether that is going to have an effect.
Yeah.
It can have.
Nope. We're about to discover.
Good skills.
That's just unbelievable. Control this net cord. Look at this.
Service over.
Played the impossible.
9-11. That was really well played. That would go into one of the 10 best shots in the book. Football with the 10 best goals.
Service over, 12-9.
Absolutely determined to make his way forward to the net with the left-hander, Liu Xiaolong. And he actually played himself into trouble.
More and more.
Service over.
Ending up on the floor. Liu Yongde was standing his ground.
10-12.
Pushing back. Eventually got the upper hand and won it.
Across the body, which of course means that the shuttle will come up to the left hander's forehand side.
It's not only that, but they work it so well, that these two guys. They know exactly what to do.
Gentlemen. Too much walking, okay? Stop.
Oh, we are real lovely. The umpire just saying now, come on, lads, stop. So much wandering around in between rallies. Good umpiring.
Yeah. It's been a strong tendency over the years to prolong the matches by just simply walking around the court, trying to compose yourself for the next rally.
Yep.
Service over, 11-14.
Qiu Zihan, not ready.
Oh, what a return.
He was certainly ready for that one.
He went for that one. Flick would have done wonders here.
Service over, 15-11.
He was quick off the marks.
Seven.
Just beginning to impose their authority on this. Oh my goodness.
Another lucky one.
Yeah. 6-point advantage now.
17-11.
Only because he's completely caught.
Oh! Yeah, Kuala desperately needs a little one of points right
13-17.
Xiaolong got that one back from Li Yong Dae. The cross court one actually caught him on his forehand and he got it back cross court again. That was one of the best shots in the rally. Normally a straight winner for Li Yong Dae. Yeah, not many. But he's not so tall, is he?
No. He's 176 and 5'9".
So they do. Look at that one there. Xiaolong is coming,
18.
Storming into the net.
Play.
It's a good comeback by the Koreans.
Yeah, just 2 points. The deficit now.
Play. Play.
Straight points.
Slight mistiming, that's enough. But the shuffle not to go over.
gets caught time and time again trying to defend the back arch defence. It's actually very, very clever play, doesn't it?
Service over, 17-19.
And switching it again. I haven't really clutched defence, I do apologise. Seeing it again.
Getting caught. And that's where, if I was Xiaolo, I would have lifted it over Li Yong Dae and tried to upset that situation.
There's just one point in it now. Well, Liu Xiaolong just asking for the court to be mopped of the perspiration. Koreans stay on court. Well, the Chinese pair go and tower down. And that's sending a very clear message both to the opponents and the umpire.
19-20.
1 point in it. They've got an awful lot of work to do if they want to keep Korea in the Sudirman Cup final. Look at the frustration from Go Sung-hyun.
Second game, level play.
Well, it's now or never as far as the Koreans are concerned. They're going to come back and win this men's doubles in three games to extend this Sudirman Cup final. And the Chinese pair of Liu Xiaolong and Qiu Zihan. Well, playing very well as a combination in that opening game. Oh. And from what I've seen of this Chinese pair, especially this year, 2013, they're absolutely growing in confidence. And therefore, having taken that first game, will be very much to their advantage.
Absolutely. I still wonder whether it was a mistake by the Koreans to choose the so-called bad end first. I think it might be more important to get the first set first.
Yeah, the psychology of being up and being a front runner
means a lot.
Yeah.
Sorry.
I was just smiling at the line judge's arm going across our lovely camera at the back there.
Service over, 2-4.
His softer shots to the net. It was way too high again, too easy to attack. There was some power into that smash.
Yeah.
6-2.
Very solid athlete, isn't he?
Service over 3-7.
Won a silver medal at the World Junior Championships playing with Chai Biao. I was a little bit surprised they haven't continued with that partnership, because Chai Biao at the moment seems to be almost in the wilderness without a regular partner. Appearing in the immaculate play of the Chinese pair.
Indecision.
Yeah.
One had to call mine.
Service over 8-5.
Sung-hyun's reaction after making the error to me. concerning. Channel attack.
It seems to work for both pairs.
Service over, 9-6.
I think it's because their defensive are so strong body-wise. Whatever the four players, whatever comes to the body of them, they're so strong. They have to be extended to be moved in order to make the mistake.
Oh, goodness.
That is good angle.
Well, he was dynamic and exciting.
He is.
He certainly is.
He's a joy to watch. He is consistently hitting over 270.
Yeah.
Eight, ten.
Good point for the Koreans here, catching up. Somehow, every time they've been catching up, getting close into 2 points, suddenly the Chinese are taking one or two and stepping away again. Oh, that's a very, very nice variation. And that's what I've been saying yesterday when you and I, we talked about it. And Li Yong Dae is standing very far back in his defense.
Yeah. Therefore, slow, vulnerable. Look how deep he is, yeah. Vulnerable to that drop shot, the disguised drop shot. Now, once again, the danger, Chinese pair. That said, though, Morton.
20 seconds, 20 seconds.
I just sense that the whole game could change in an instant. Oh, there we go. My goodness, mate. Four Chinese players in the top five speeds. This week.
Play.
You know, going back to my point, Morton, I just sort of think, you know, a couple of points by the Koreans, if they were to get back level, I don't know under pressure situations how this Chinese pair would react, because of course when they won the All England, they weren't expected to win. They weren't seeded.
No, and they were cruising.
And they were cruising. Mm. And all of a sudden, now their teammates, their country expects. They've got the burden of expectation. And I don't know from experience how they'll deal with that.
I know where you want to go, and I also think that the Korean pair is more experienced if it really comes to touch and go. But somehow I just feel with this Chinese pair, they're on a roll. They're in their own little world at the moment. They're in a comfort zone. They really play well. And they don't see what else is going on the outside.
Yeah.
That's once again, the simple shot got all the difficult ones back.
Service over, 12-9.
Again, this three-point lead. Just to indicate that they want the shuffle changed.
Cool,
line judge. Goodness me, they have been very, very good this week, the line judges. And short. It's difficult to serve to see.
Service over, 13,
very, very difficult
10,
to serve, to, especially on the left-hand side. Just found the gap.
14-11.
Now, I just sense this
service
is where
over, 12,
to make
14.
Push. They want to win this. I guarantee you, they're trying all they can.
Yeah.
At any given time. Need a little bit of luck on their side. Didn't get it here.
Service over.
There's no
15,
doubt in their
12.
Desire and their effort. But there's always stages of match, isn't there, where you can just sense as a player. And remember, you were absolute master at it. You know, just close, and then you just pile on the pressure. Three intense points,
yes.
And
that's one of them.
Yeah.
That's so delicately played. Not only
service,
I know he hit
over,
the net, but the idea
13,
and the touch
15.
Of how he played it was so nice.
Out of the machine. Carlo is really up there.
Over.
Adding on the pressure. 1, 2, 3.
16-13.
And this time it was Li Yong Dae on the floor. Xiaolong got the better of him here. Change of pace. Once Li Yong Dae had been pushed back, he was on the floor, as you're saying. There was absolutely no way he could have got up and moved forward to that block. Previous times that these two nations have met each other in the final of the Sudirman Cup, of course, Korea beat China in Eindhoven in 2003.
Yeah.
On the two occasions in 1997 and 2009, China won the final without Korea scoring a point.
in both the finals. It's a lot.
Say that Xiaolong is really, really good on serve and return. And the next one, the first three shots, he's excellent on it. Serving really well.
Away from a third point in the final, which of course would mean final over and Sudirman Cup champions once more. Serve a little more than he did last time, so that's better.
So often there have been 2 points and having the chance,
service
and then
over.
The Chinese are extending it again
15.
To 3 points.
That's gone wrong. It is Sudirman Cup point now for China. Four match point opportunities in this men's doubles for a Chinese whitewash in this final. Two Chinese players go and embrace head coach Li Yongbo. Victory in this doubles, 21-19, 21-17, and China have their ninth Sudirman Cup title, their fifth consecutive title, playing in their 10th consecutive final. What a record they have. Well, after the huge scare in the quarter-final against Indonesia, China have got better and better. Four. The players, the elation for this particular men's doubles pair, well, they started China's Sudirman Cup campaign and they finished it. And they finished it in fine style, 21-19, 21-17 in 45 minutes. So a ninth Sudirman Cup title for China. My goodness, what a tournament it's been. Their confirmation, the final against Korea. It was the fourth time these two teams have met each other in the final of the Sudirman Cup. And the third time that China has beaten Korea. Three love, the margin of the victory. But China throughout this week have really been fairly phenomenal. In their group, they didn't drop a match. Today's final, of course, all started with the mixed doubles. And the world number ones, Qiu Zihan and Liu Xiaolong, overcoming Go Sung-hyun and Kim Ha-ma in two straight games. 21-13, 21-15 in 37 minutes. And then it was the turn of Chen Long. Well, he's remained undefeated all week. But what a spirited fight today from Lee Dong-kyung. But in the end, the Olympic bronze medalist, the All England champion from China. Well, just too much in his armory and two straight games there too. 2, 21-15, 21-10. Then came the men's doubles and the All England champions, Liu Xiaolong and Qiu Zihan, up against the world number 2s, Sung-hyun and Yong Dae. Well, this was the fifth meeting between these two pairs, and China had won the last two. They kept that run going. They really started in such strong form. 21-19 and 21-17 in the second game. So that was the three love victory. Of course, the last two matches are not contested once the Sudirman Cup has been decided. So the three love victory is all that it took for China to defend their title. Well, in their semi-final, I can tell you it was a great match against Denmark, and we ought to spare us a thought really for both the beaten semi-finalists. Thailand were there for the first time in their history, only the seventh nation to reach the semi-final of this prestigious event. But China's match against Denmark, well, once again, it all started with mixed doubles, and it was the world and Olympic champions, Jiang Nan and Zhao Yunlei, who became the Olympic bronze medalists. Fisher Nielsen and Christina Peterson. Two straight games, 21-15, 21-12. Of course, the world and Olympic champions not selected for today's final. Oh, geez, China have the strength in depth on their team. Madness is what makes them such awesome moments. Well, yesterday's semi-final, yesterday evening, the second match was men's singles, and Jan Jorgensen from Denmark, who played throughout the competition, all of Denmark's men's singles matches, he had been selected. But yesterday against Chen Long, as indeed he was today, was in supreme form. Absolute symmetry in the scoreline with the victory game to the world number two, Chen Long, 21-16, 21-16. He had some great rallies, but one always felt that the physique and power and consistency of this man was going to win through. Then it was the turn of the men's doubles and a repeat of the Olympic final. But it was a reversed result of the Olympic final, because the Olympic silver medalists from Denmark, Mathias Boe and Carsten Mogensen, the world and Olympic champions, Taeyun and Fu Haifeng, in two games, 21-16, 21-17. And of course, the world number ones, keeping Denmark's hopes alive in the semi-final and extending the match to a fourth match within the tie. Which meant that we had the women's singles and the Olympic champion, Li Xuanrei, up against the 19-year-old of Denmark. Well, the game started so well. She was 10-all in the opening game, but from then on, the world number one and Olympic champion. Just upped her intensity, gave us a wonderful display of her array of shots, her court movements, and just showed us at times with some absolute brilliance just why she is the world number one. But what a great experience for the youngster from Dorfus. So of course that was semi-final. This is the Chinese team now. Of course, the Sudirman Cup is a biannual event. So it will be 2 years before another Sudirman Cup competition. But as I was saying earlier, it's been an absolute delight this week to see the emergence of some new nations really challenging the established nations in mixed team competitions. One of those nations we can take note of is, of course, Thailand, who reached their first ever semi-final. Of course, that semi-final against Korea all started with the mixed doubles as well, and Sukkit Prakamol and Sara Lee from Tongkang, despite twice being World Championship bronze medalists could not deal with the pace and the strengths of their Korean opponents. Go Sung-hyun and Kim Ha-na, two straight games, 21-18, 21-19. It was a good match. But then Boonsak Ponsana, the 31-year-old from Bangkok. Well, he's been as high as five in the world rankings, and he played yesterday like a world number five. He was an absolute delight to watch, showing his skills and his court craft against the forever hard-working Lee Dong Kyung. But Boonsak Ponsana, who was only playing his second match in the campaign, was just too good for his Korean opponent. Two straight games, 21-9, 21-12. And so it was the turn of the men's doubles, with the match poised at one match apiece. World number twos, Go Sung-hyun and Li Yong Dae. Well, it was a very explosive match against Manipong Jongjik and Huan Huapet. But in the end, the world number twos just a little more organized at times against this very new Thailand pairing. Oh, a couple of times we saw that throughout the week, haven't we? Players rushing off to get a new racket. But despite every effort by the Thailand pair, Koreans came through 21-12, 21-11 in 34 minutes. So we had the women's singles and the number five and six ranked players in the world of badminton. The youngster, the 18-year-old Ratchanuk Intanon, who of course played the All England final and recently won her first Super Series event, became the youngest ever Super Series winner at the India event in Delhi. She was up against Sung Ji Hyun, the 21-year-old from Seoul, and the 21-year-olds for Korea hit home the victory, 21-17, 21-14, to secure Korea's place in their seventh Super Series Sudirman Cup final. So to the presentation for the bronze medals, the Denmark team and the Thailand team ever time. Of course, Denmark have been semi-finalists, a staggering 11 times here at the Sudirman Cup. Presentation party, and the presentation of the bronze, silver, and gold medals. Party forward. Thank you. have twice been beaten finalists in the Sudirman Cup, but their record of 11 semi-final appearances from 13 Sudirman Cup competitions is a fine, fine record, and as a Dane yourself, you must be very proud of that.
Absolutely, I think the Danish team has done well in this tournament. They were not really hot favourites, but I think they have played really well and made it, which is great. The thing is that this team, for once, was only played by the same lineup in the whole tournament, which is obviously showing that we haven't got the same kind of depth in the team as we've had in the past.
Yeah, very good point. But there are. It's a very good mix of the team, wasn't it? The experienced players with some very young players.
I agree, but still we must say that for once we have a complete first lineup. There's no doubt who's playing first or second in the team at the moment, and obviously we need to get that more competition into the team, fighting for the places.
Once in men's doubles for the first match was the only difference from the team that was put out against every other team that they played against. Well, this is a proud, proud moment for Thailand. She's receiving medals as well. Yesterday afternoon, receiving her medal. She wasn't selected for the semi-final women's doubles. It was a surprise selection, but sadly we never got that far. Decided to select Sara Lee, playing with Sapsuri, Sara Lee, who played the mixed doubles in the first match on the semi-final. And I know we've talked about it before, Morten, but there are so many very, very good youngsters. There's Sapsuri, she's down to play the women's doubles as Arachanuk receives her bronze medal. It's a very exciting time for Thailand.
It is. They've been working very hard over the years, and for the first time in perhaps ever, they have such a depth in the team, and they have so many youngsters coming on. Even in the ladies' things, it's not only Arachanuk, I think they have four, maybe even five very good young players coming on. The men's doubles is new. They have their second men's singles player as well as a new player. So they have lots of new players coming up.
Yeah, and of course, we'll receive his medal. Many from Yong Dae, very exciting talent in the men's doubles, as you say. Second best at the Sudirman Cup, beaten finalists in the first ever Sudirman Cup staged in Jakarta in 1989, reached the final in Glasgow in 1997. when they were the finalists 4 years ago, losing out once again to China in Guangzhou. But of course, they have been three times champions in 1991 in Copenhagen. They retained the title 2 years later in Birmingham. And when the event was staged as an independent event rather than coupled with the World Individual Championships for the first time, it was staged on its own in Anaheim, in Eindhoven in 2003. They won the title there as well. Well, Li Yongdae looking bitterly disappointed. He sets his standards so high. Korea, as always, so united in team efforts, so supportive of one another. And their fighting spirits as a nation in these team competitions really is a wonderful example to all badminton nations. We looked at it before the start, Morten. We could see a possibility for them, but it wasn't to be.
No, but I think they played a good team match again, a good tournament. And as we said, they only came into the tournament as seeded number six, and they got to the final. And again, showing just what you said, they have such a strong team spirit, but they also have good depth in the team. They can play many, many good players. And I think they deserve to go.
Yes, they've got a couple of very good women's singles players. Women's doubles has always been a strength. Mixed doubles possibilities. A seventh final. And a fourth time. A silver medal. So China, the champions once again, and the Chinese team has become a tradition for them. Go in front of the podium to congratulate all the medalists. Led by Li Yongbo, head coach. And the Chinese team, well, so much strength in depth. The presentation party being made to wait while the congratulations amongst the players. Continues. Well, you can see from the number of players what a big squad China has brought. And every single one of them is a world-class player.
Could easily play on the other team.
Yeah. So the presentation party of Geraldine Brown, Vice President of the Badminton Federation, or Badminton World Federation. And she is accompanied by Mr. Jiang Jianggu, Deputy Chairman of the Li-Ning Group. Just received her medal. She was absolutely superb in the first of the matches today. On the final day, the mixed doubles. Wong Xiao Li, who was playing with Yu Young. Well, they look a class above everyone else. They really are superb in the mixed doubles pair. Olympic champion. Medal. Yeah, they should look happy. Maybe it's one of them for China. scare in their quarter final against Indonesia. Of course, they played Indonesia in the group. They beat Indonesia 5 love. They came to the quarter final, and the luck of the draw meant that China had to play Indonesia once more. It all came down to the fifth and final match of the women's doubles. It was a thriller. So scraped through a quarter final 3-2, won their semi final 3-1, and the final 3-0. A lesson in how to get better and better. Qiu Zihan played the mixed doubles, big power player. And Qiu Zihan remained undefeated in the men's singles. A wonderful Sudirman Cup campaign. So we await for the trophy. The magnificent Sudirman Cup trophy, which stands 80 centimeters high, made of gold-plated solid silver. It is a magnificent trophy. The part of it in the shape of a shuttlecock. A replica of the Borobudur temple you can see on the top of the trophy. As all the teams are asked to stand while we have the national anthem for China. So the Chinese team and the Chinese fans can celebrate another memorable victory for China. Well, it's been a tremendous week, and we have so thoroughly enjoyed all the badminton, all 30 teams who have competed in this Li-Ning BWF Sudirman Cup have played their part in making it a very special week indeed. But a ninth Sudirman Cup to China. They really are a phenomenal team. As they pose with the dignitaries and the presentation party. And it is a moment that China can cherish once again. So that is it for this year and the Sudirman Cup. It has been a great week. We've seen some marvellous badminton throughout. But as I say, China, once again, are champions. From all of us here in Kuala Lumpur, from Morton Frost and myself, Jill Clark. Until the next time, bye-bye.
Yeah.